I'm Debbie Young. Two Palm Coast firefighters ended up in the hospital on Wednesday afternoon after being dispatched to a suicide attempt involving a mixture of household chemicals. It happened on Black Bear Lane. The sheriff's office says the man attempting suicide mixed bleach, ammonia, and a few other things. He was getting chemical burns from inhaling the fumes. When firefighters entered the house, they were overcome by the fumes. Two firefighters and the apparent attempted suicide victim were all taken to Florida Hospital Flagler. The man had chemical burns in his mouth. Flagler County Fire Chief Don Petito says this kind of suicide attempt was a fad in Japan before coming over to the U.S. It's now being seen as a suicide method, particularly in Orlando in South Florida. It was a grisly trend in Japan back in 2008 when 500 Japanese men, women, and children reportedly killed themselves through this method in the first half of that year, following instructions posted on the web.
This portion of WNZF Local News, a service of the Daytona Beach International Airport. Fly to the Big Apple in a New York minute on JetBlue from the Daytona Beach International Airport.
Flagler County man Dante Wilson, an assistant manager at Wendy's in Bunnell, is accused of stealing his employer's bank bag full of cash. He told authorities that he was robbed in the Wells Fargo parking lot when he was trying to deposit $900 for the restaurant. But after Wells Fargo employees disputed the story, he then changed his story and said it happened at a Bank of America. Wilson was seen on surveillance at the Bank of America, walking in and out of the bank without any confrontations. Wilson was arrested on charges including grand theft, perjury, false report of a crime, and falsely calling 911. Rich Carroll, WNZF Local News.
Flagler Beach leaders burrow through budget talks, including a potentially big pay raise for one employee in particular. Ben Smith has the story.
Citizens in Flagler Beach should prepare for increases in property taxes and service fees following last week's City Commission budget workshop. Officials say the increases are necessary following years of stagnant rates. Part of the increase will likely fund an across-the-board 4% pay increase for city workers. However, commissioners floated a possible 30% pay raise for City Manager Larry Newsom.
I do appreciate the commission doing that, but at the end of the day, the pay raise has to factor into what the millage rate's going to be.
Newsom is budgeted a 7% raise to nearly $99,000 per year. Commission Chair Jane Mealy suggested a $120,000 cap for Newsom in the budget proposal, a number he says is secondary.
I'm only as good as my staff, so it doesn't matter if I'm making 93, 95, 100, or 150. I want to make sure my staff is supported first.
The Flagler Beach Commission will hold its first public hearing on the proposed budget September 6th. For Flagler's Morning News, I'm Ben Smith.
David Snellgrove has been on death row in Florida for 15 years, and his lawyers were back in court Wednesday for yet another hearing about his future. Snellgrove has already been sentenced to die twice for the double murders of Glenn and Vivian Fowler in their Palm Coast home in 2000. Both of the juries recommending death did so on a split vote. Last year, the U.S. Supreme Court declared Florida's method of sentencing people to death unconstitutional, and earlier this year, the legislature approved a new law requiring unanimous juries when recommending death. Some 400 people are on Florida's death row. Maybe half of them are eligible for new sentencing under the new law, as Snellgrove is one of them. Another hearing scheduled in the case for October. Three more Palm Coast homes were vandalized sometime before dawn on Tuesday.
Throughout the month of August, vandals spray painting garage doors, sides of homes, and even vehicles have caused damage to properties throughout Flagler County. Flagler Sheriff's detectives have followed all leads in an attempt to identify the suspects. While they believe the graffiti is related, they do not believe it is racially motivated or gang-related. Sheriff Rick Staley asks if you see anything that may be related to these crimes or any crime in Flagler County, that you please call the Flagler County Sheriff's Office at 386-313-4911. Callers can remain anonymous and may be eligible for a reward of up to $1,000. For Flagler's Morning News, I'm Mary Rose Hamilton.
And now you're up to date on Flagler's Morning News. I'm Debbie Young.